time of year. You know, January 1st. Y'all know that day, right? The holiest day of the college football season. That is correct. However, do know there's been some games that are not going to be on January the 1st, like always. But what are we talking about here, big boy? What are we talking about here? Oh, you know, the college football playoff and the New Year's Six. So, here we go, baby. It is time. It is time to talk the college football playoff. I did a preview for some of the New Year's, for some of the New Year's Day bowl games that weren't the New Year's Six last week, and some other bowl games as well. Again, congratulations already to all the bowl winners who have already played and stuff like that. And I will recap each and every one of the New Year's Six bowl games along with some others as well. But first off, you gotta start with the Cotton Bowl. That is tomorrow night. That is going to be Oklahoma, the Big 12 champion, versus the SEC runner-up in Florida. And I gotta tell you, Florida's missing a bunch of guys. A bunch of guys are opting out of this game. And Oklahoma is riding high. They have been on a roll since they lost to Iowa State back in October. And honestly, these New Year's Six games, aside from the almost all bowl games aside from the playoff now, do not really mean anything except for one thing, and that is to build momentum into next season. What in the world are we going to see, you know, from Spencer Rattler and stuff like that, you know, from this bowl game, and how will that play out going into next year with all these recruiting classes and stuff like that coming in? And guys are coming in that are freshmen, are ready to get rumbling and tumbling on that field. So, Kyle Trask projected, hopefully he will win the Heisman. If not, I mean, that'll be a shame. But, I mean, yeah, Florida and Oklahoma are going to be one hell of a game. Both these teams are very much motivated. Both these teams are talking a lot of trash. And, you know, it's going to be very fun to see. On January the 1st, though, we have the undefeated Cincinnati Bearcats taking on the two-loss Georgia Bulldogs. And the Bulldogs have been, again, they've also been riding high after a couple of bad losses to start the season. They've been rolling ever since with JT Daniels at the wheel. And, you know, Georgia, you know, I wrote them off completely throughout the entire season, you know, after that Florida loss. And, you know, now that they've gotten hot, things are looking kind of nice out there in Athens. But, oh, this undefeated Cincinnati group is a tough, tough bunch. Very tough bunch. Desmond Ridder is the quarterback for Cincinnati. I've highlighted him several times, and he has been going off these last several weeks. And, you know, Cincinnati is in a great position to, you know, end the season undefeated. A crazy bowl season in a crazy year, crazier than 2007. You know, Cincinnati has the chance to end up undefeated. And things are looking quite nice for the Bearcats. And the momentum for them going into next year, I think, would be, you know, because they have a much, if 2021 does not get impacted by COVID, the schedule is there. It is strong. It is very tough. It is right there. You know, you got Notre Dame and Indiana for Cincinnati in 2021. Two teams that are also looking to prove themselves, you know, and stuff like that. And Georgia, you know, They want the SEC so bad. They want the SEC East. They want the SEC Championship. They want to go to a national championship. But they have to get over the humps first. They have to get over, you know, losing twice in a season like this, or, you know, getting the place in that. If you think this is about, oh, well, Georgia was unmotivated, oh, well, Cincinnati is trash, you can take those narratives out right now. So those two narratives are trash. Both these teams are damn well motivated to play this game. Both these teams are damn well sure they're going to play this game, and it's going to be one hell of a time. But next up, the first college football playoff semifinal in Arlington instead of the Rose Bowl, baby. That's what's up. And it's going to be Alabama. Dominant. Looked great in every single game they played this year against the number 4 Notre Dame Fighting Irish, who are obviously looking to prove themselves, who really want to erase that Clemson blowout that they were handed a couple weeks back. They gotta, if Alabama, you know, steam walks through Notre Dame, I'm not gonna be completely surprised. But Notre Dame can keep this game close. Ian Book can keep this game close. Kyron Williams can keep this game close for the Irish. If that Irish defense can make plays and stop Mac Jones, Najee Harris, Devontae Smith, you know, that triplets, you know, if they can stop them, keep them off the field for even, you know, a few minutes just for Notre Dame to get some momentum, I think there'll be a lot of a good chance. Meanwhile, Sugar Bowl, right after that, Clemson, Ohio State. Ohio State's only played 6 games. Clemson, Dabo Sweeney's talking a lot of trash to Ohio State. Talking a lot of trash about the Buckeyes. The Buckeyes, they are definitely more rested, more well, you know, at ease. You know, instead of these other teams that have played 10 or 11 games, and I get that, I get it. With Ohio State, could come in, you know, Justin Fields and company, they could come in and they could, you know, play a damn good game with Clemson. Clemson was blindsided by Notre Dame the first time, so you cannot overlook the Buckeyes. Buckeyes are very talented, you know. And I know everybody's going to be like, oh, well, you know, this is an invitational. And you're right, it is an invitational. But, I mean, the BCS would have gotten it the same way. Again, the BCS would have gotten it the same way. We would have had these 4 teams in the playoff anyway, you know. So you could throw those arguments out the window at the moment. And I already talked about, you know, how we should expand the playoff and stuff like that last week as well. So what about January the 2nd? There's games on January the 2nd? Well, we got to have exclusive windows and stuff now. So instead of, you know, having 8 bowl games on January the 1st like it was back in the old days, we got to spread them all out. And thus, we start January the 2nd off, obviously, with some, you know, other bowl games first, but out back in the Gator, you know. And then we get to the Fiesta Bowl matchup, which will be Oregon, the Pac-12 champions, against the Big 12 runners-up, Iowa State. And let me tell you, Oregon's pretty interesting. You know, the Tyler Shaw was the quarterback for most of the season. I'm not sure who the quarterback is now for the Ducks. And Iowa State, you know, Breece Hall, Brock Purdy, Matt Campbell, you know, they're looking for some vengeance. They're looking to beat up on somebody, you know, following their collapse in the Big 12 championship game. They're looking to get something in there. And if Iowa State wants to keep this up, they got to win this bowl game. They got to keep this up. You know, it's going into next year. There's going to be lots of expectations placed on Matt Campbell. He's expected to be, you know, going higher, going up the ladder with this Iowa State Cyclones team now that you've gone to the Big 12 championship for the first time. The expectations are going to go up, and you got to meet them. You can't meet them, it's okay. You know, we can't really, you know, project about one season to the next. So, you know, just got to try your best. At Oregon, I think this game is just going to prove, you know, what in the world the Pac-12, you know, what their place will be in all of this once it's all said and done. Because 5 of the 7, you know, college football playoff games is, you know, college football playoff semifinals, Pac-12 has missed it 5 times. Only Oregon and Washington have been to the playoffs. And neither of those 2 teams could come home with the championship of the Pac-12. So the Pac-12 needs this game. They need their champion to show up in a good game. They need their champion to show up against better competition. Because Pac-12 has been rough and tumble this year. Everybody in that conference has a loss, and none of the wins the Pac-12 teams have over each other were good wins. So Oregon needs this win. They need this win, definitely. And last but not least is the Orange Bowl. I know the Fiesta's after the Orange Bowl, but I want to talk about the Orange Bowl last. North Carolina has players opting out. Three of their top five stars opted out thanks to the NFL draft. And Texas A&M, they are looking, you know, they're angry too. Well, them and Cincinnati are pretty angry with where they are, you know, to end the season. And A&M wants to whoop some ass. But can they whoop some ass? Can they? You know, North Carolina is no slouch. No slouch at all. Sam Howell, you know, in his, I presume it will be his final game at North Carolina, could go off. Mac Brown has got something good going down there in North Carolina. And if things, you know, if there weren't two bad losses, two really head-scratching losses, this team would only have one loss right now. This team would only have one loss. And it's a damn good team. North Carolina is a really good team. You know, so A&M, they have to keep the balanced attack going. And for them, and for Jimbo and company next year, you know, the thing for them is going to be, you know, how do we get over the Alabama hump? How do we get over that? They got Florida this year. They beat them this year. How do they get over Alabama? How do they get over, you know, an SEC team that could potentially rise up like LSU did in 2019? How can they get over that hump? That's what the problem with A&M is that they have to get over, you know, certain hurdles to be able to win the SEC for the first time. And they haven't done it since they've gotten here. They haven't done anything since they've gotten here in this conference. They need to do something. North Carolina, Mack Brown is going to be carrying this momentum in the next year. I mean, they were already hyped up this year, again, with, you know, the season being the way it was. And now this year, you know, going into 2021, things are looking even better for this team. I'm telling you, North Carolina is going to be a team to watch for a while. Maybe they can challenge the Clemson Tigers in the ACC if things continue to go the way they've been going for the Tar Heels. So, there you have it. That's what I'm thinking, you know, about the New Year's Six and the college football playoff. So, want to know what you guys think, you know, like, share, comment, subscribe, hitting on the notification bell and all that good stuff. And I'll see you after